Продовжуємо роботу в українському кризі.
We continue our work in the Ukraine Crisis Media Center, and now the floor is given to Colonel Andriy Lysenko, Ministry of Defense of Ukraine spokesman, NATO-related issues. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. Now to your attention is the information about the events in the EDO zone and about the training of Ukrainian armed forces in the firing grounds of the country. The Lugansk sector yesterday, the situation was really tense. Right after midnight, Russian occupation forces delivered heavy 30-minute shelling to Troitsk, and during which the enemy launched 45 mines at the position of Ukrainian armed forces. At the same time, the militants delivered shelling of Novoalexandrovka, and later, after 1 a.m., the occupants opened artillery fire at Troitsk. And it is worth noting that all three shellings were from the temporarily occupied Kalinovo, from the direction of Kalinovo. And also at 11 a.m., the militants delivered shelling with the use of grenade launchers to Stary Aydar. And during the day, at line of contact, it was calm, and the militants restarted its activity after 8 p.m., and they delivered mortar shelling in Malinovo and Katerinovka. And one armed provocation with the use of small arms was carried out by the militants in Novozvanivka, Novotashkivka. And yesterday in the Lugansk sector, there were 8 shellings delivered by the enemy, including 5 with the use of heavy weapons. In the Donetsk sector, yesterday there were 2 shellings, both near Avdiivka. The enemy used grenade launchers and small arms. The Mariupol sector. Yesterday, 3/4 of all enemy armed provocations were recorded in Pavlopil-Shirokina, part of front line. The enemy delivered fire with the use of grenade launchers of different systems and also used small arms. In this part of front line, enemy shellings were both during the day and at night. Between 7 and 10 p.m., the militants delivered 1 shelling with the use of small arms in Novomikhailovka, Berezove, and Novotroitska. Yesterday in the Mariupol sector, there were 12 shellings delivered by the militants at Ukrainian positions. During the last 24 hours, and the result of the military actions, no Ukrainian serviceman was killed or wounded. But yesterday, in Yestenitsa Luganska, one serviceman trapped a wire trap and died in the explosion. Our hearts go out to the relatives of the serviceman who died. Police officers and SBU officers detained a former militant in Toretsk. It was identified that in 2014, he, during several months, was the member of Vostok militant group. Later, he left the militant group and was hiding in Russia. Then he returned to Novgorodska village of Donetsk Oblast. Investigation and court hearing are pending. There were training of the National Guardsmen that guard nuclear power plants. The training envisaged full battle readiness of troops and exit to positions for defense of facilities, search and detention of the subverters. Yesterday in Odessa, there were official opening of Seabreeze 2017 international training opening, and 31 ships, skaters, vessel, 29 aircraft, and 3,000 servicemen will participate in training. This will be 2 weeks training. And this will be in the territory of Odessa and Mykolaiv Oblast. And these events will include training in anti-boat, anti-ship, and air defense. Thank you. Do you have questions? No questions. Thank you. And goodbye.